This is Dr. Martin's supplemental lecture on chapter 26, section 3. I'm going to be talking about the mammals. Let's talk about some, so this is again class mammalia. Some general features. Of this group. You probably know these. Mammary glands that produce milk for the young. The presence of fur. But there's also some other characteristics of mammals that are important. They are endothermic. So they have a relatively high metabolic rate, and so they can regulate their own temperature. They have a larger brain per body mass compared to other orders of vertebrates or other groups of vertebrates. The respiratory system. Now has an added structure to assist in respiration, and that is a muscular sheet called a diaphragm that is located between the thorax and the abdomen. So it increases the efficiency of moving air in and out of the body. Another characteristic, let's see, I'm going to erase some of these. So we're on number 6. The mammals are characterized by their teeth. They have teeth, we have, and mammals in general, have teeth that are differentiated for different purposes. So we have, for example, incisors that are for cutting, biting. We have canines for poking, grabbing. We have molars for grinding or pulverizing. Foods. So we have, unlike the reptiles, we have teeth that have different functions. Another characteristic is that mammals exhibit extended parenting. In other words, the young are kept with either both parents or just the mother or father. For an extended time compared to the reptiles and other vertebrates. Of course, they are amniotes, but all but one group actually have live birth. So we'll talk about one group that still lays eggs. So most have live birth, and one last characteristic, we'll make this number 10, they have, as with the birds, they have a four-chambered heart. That delivers blood to the organs more efficiently. So as with the birds, we have two circuits of blood flow. And this increases, again, the efficiency at which oxygen can be delivered to the organs of the body. Okay, I think that's a good list of general features of the mammals. Let's talk a little bit about the origin of the mammals. Most scientists believe that the mammals arose from mammal-like reptiles. The oldest mammalian fossil that we have dates back about 220 million years. The early mammals actually did coexist with the dinosaurs. But during that time, they were most likely nocturnal. They were small. They're probably omnivores, taking advantage of whatever type of food might be available. When the dinosaurs went extinct because of meteor impact, that gave the mammals many new habitats to grow into, to evolve, and so many, many species originated during that time. When we look at living groups of mammals, there are three main groups. And so the most primitive are a group of mammals that are called monotremes. There are maybe five species in the world of this group. They actually lay eggs. They do produce milk, but it's secreted by small glands in the skin. So they don't have a nipple that would increase the efficiency at which they can get milk. They actually have to lick it off the fur of mom. The species included is a platypus. And I believe we have one at the Memphis Zoo. In addition, there are maybe four species of echidna. One example is a spiny anteater. And again, I think we have one species of that at the Memphis Zoo. These guys are primarily found in Australia and New Guinea, that area. They're considered fairly primitive among the mammals. Okay, the second group of mammals are some that you probably are familiar with. And so these are called marsupials. And these mammals actually produce milk, and they do have nipples to secrete milk. They do have a special organ called the placenta that is actually composed of maternal and fetal tissue. These mammals adults are actually born very immature. And the embryo, or fetus, actually has to crawl. Fetus crawls out of the female reproductive tract and goes into a pouch that mom has. It's a maternal pouch, and that pouch is called a marsupium. The examples of marsupials that you're familiar with: kangaroos, koalas, and the opossum. Okay, that's one that we have in North America. That's the only one that we have in North America. They do have a higher metabolic rate than the monotremes. So they have a higher metabolism. The marsupials were actually very abundant past geological time. However, they underwent a decline, and so at present there's only, we can only see marsupials in Australia or regions around Australia and in North and South America, but they're much more abundant actually in Australia. The third group of mammals are the mammals that you're most familiar with, I would think. And this group, so this is number three, these are called the eutherians, and, or in layman's terms, these are the placental mammals. So these guys actually have a more complex placenta compared to the monotremes. They have longer pregnancies. So the embryo or the fetus develops to a greater extent within the uterus of mom. Fetus develops in the uterus. There are approximately 20 living orders of the placental mammals, and I'm not going to ask you to learn all of those. I'm going to just give you a list of five terms or names of groups that I want you to know. So again, these are orders. Maybe I should use the black marker. Rodentia. These have the most number of species. Of all the mammals, there are more species of within this group compared to any other order. So this obviously includes the rats, the mice, the squirrels, and A second order that I would like you to know are the Legomorpha, and these are the rabbits, hares, and a small group that you can see out west. They're called pikas. These guys have modifications of the lower leg for hopping. And let's see. The carnivora, or the carnivores, includes the wolf. There's some wild dog breeds, cat, felines, and so on. A couple of other orders that I want you to know, just two more. So this would be D, Chiroptera, and these are the bats. And these are one of the few groups of animals that have developed flight. And last but not least are the primates. So the primates include the monkeys, the great apes. So the chimpanzee. Gorilla, orangutan. And those apes that are more closely related to humans. Okay, so that's five orders that I want you to know just a little bit about. And then the three main groups of mammals, the monotremes, marsupials, and eutherians, the true placental mammals. And then in the very beginning, I talked about some general characteristics of mammals.